into the African food. This is the chicken that you need. This is the smoked chicken. It's not like American smoked chicken. I'll let y'all just see. It just, I can't explain it. It's smoke, but it smells like fire. Like, I can't explain it. You just smell like the wood that it was smoked in. It just, that's my best interpretation of analogy for it. It just, there's smoked meat. Smells like fire. It's not like the American smoked meat. And this is a fish. It has a fishy, smoky smell too. That's unique. He said that you take the head off and you have to like go through it and get the bones out. It's just like, this is what, I bought three of them. This is what gives the, to me, gives the Egusi the authentic taste and smell. It's the smoked fish and the smoked chicken. And then I bought another thing of melon seeds, Egusi. And I think these were $6.99. I don't know where the tag went. But it is the whole Egusi, the melon seeds. This is why you reach back, because you get the freshest meat to me. These are the cows. Yeah. I had to leave, so I'm going to add them in. From Africa. And let it do what it do. And there's my onion. I cannot tell you how much easier it is to chop onion with a sharp knife. It makes all the difference in the world. I didn't used to understand because I used to always be scared I would cut myself if I kept my knife sharp, and I had a lot of kids. So I just don't wash it in the dishwater. I just rinse it. So it's not left in the dishwater and I won't forget to cut myself. Now I'm going to add this to my, hold on. Y'all can see it jump off the diving board into the pot. There it goes swimming with the chicken and the beef and the fishes. Boil for the next few hours. And then I will blend up my egusi seeds while this is cooking. Stay locked. My meat has been boiling. It hasn't really broke down yet, but I just want you to see where I am. Still kind of tough. These are the cow feet. And I did put two of the American chicken, smoked chicken in here. As long as I have some of the African for that flavor, I'm okay. I just didn't want to use all of the American. But this is the African smoked chicken. And that's my fish that is soft. I had it soaking for about 3 hours. I left. I'm going to save that for when all of this is done, because I want to have the pieces together. I don't want it to be all broken up. And to this, I'm going to chop some onions and let it keep boiling. Okay, the meat is almost done. So what I'm going to do is take all of it up. Sisi's video, I will follow her. She said not to put too much water in it because you want the flavors to be concentrated in the egusi. Take all the meat out and bones. I have enough room. Oops. So I can use this pot to fry the onions and incorporate the melon seeds. Stay locked, y'all. I'll be back. I'm having a class. I'm on break. I just thought I'd show you how far I've got. Stay locked. Okay, these are the melon seeds and the pumpkin seeds. I just put the whole jar of this brand. And now, let's pulse it. thought I was going to post. Hold on, y'all. Let me try to make this. I'm going to add the palm oil. I don't know how I'm going to get this out of here. I should have heated it up. This is hot pepper paste, but it's not hot. It is like sweet red bell peppers. Thank you. I'm gonna let that fry for a little while. Because the other way, like you would use the wet red bell pepper puree, you don't have to do that step because it's already, all the water is already cooked out of it. So now I'm gonna add my meat back to the pot. Try to take most of the bones out of it. Or you can leave them in there if you want. Some of the broth back. I like sucking on the bones, but some people might not. My fish. Let this cook down again. I'm just gonna pour all my broth in there and cook it on high. It's too flavorful to just leave it out.
Ha ha ha!
added a secret ingredient. Some tripe. Actually, some manure. I took the tripe out of my own noodle and put it in. Now I'm trying, that's the juicy. I'm kind of trying to cook some of the water off. I shouldn't have put the extra broth, so I'm just trying to finish breaking down the chicken. By letting it fast boil out, then I'm going to add the egusi and the spinach. In about 20 minutes, it'll be done. Simmer. Lord, please bless him in Jesus' holy name.